Good day folks, in this video we can take a look into the recovery process of a Cloudera manager, okay, or we can say the migrating Cloudera manager service from one server to another. So in case of recovery, so you already have a backup of the database and the files, and for migration, so we can take at this time and do that. So first you have to log into the server your Cloudera manager is running, and we need to make sure so you have taken the proper backup. Okay, so this is the server where your Cloudera manager server is running. So you can refer this file etc Cloudera SSM server, then db.properties, and this file contain the credentials. Okay, so what is the type of the database? So here it's using embedded database. So you can try to connect, or we can take the backup by using pg dump. Okay, so this is the command we can use for taking the backup: pg underscore dump hyphen u, this is the username here, then hyphen p. So you need to specify this port. Why? Because it's using maybe it's using the non-default port here, and this is the database. So similarly, you have to take the backup of each and every dbs. So there will be multiple dbs, so based on the Cloudera management service. And also you have to take make a note of this directory, so slash etc Cloudera SSM server, also slash var lib Cloudera SSM server. So these two directories you need to take the backup. So that I think that I have already covered in my previous video. So here we are just shutting down the Cloudera service here in this particular node, I mean the master. So the master is 94 public IP, so that is the one which I connected, and I am moving that service into this 124. Okay, so the first step is take the backup of the directories as well as the DB, then turn off the data, turn off the CDH component, just stop that services, and then whatever the services you have to stop all the CDH services. Then once that is done, so you can stop that Cloudera management service. So once this is completed, turn off Cloudera server and server DB and agent across all the machines. So here I'm going to stop the Cloudera server and service Cloudera hyphen SSM hyphen server stop. Then I need to, since I used embedded DB or default DB, so I need to use the DB service also. Then I need to Cloudera SSM fn agent stop. So the agent you have to stop across all the nodes, whatever the nodes you have, so you have to do it across all the nodes. Okay, so that's it. The next part is, so you have to copy the backup to that particular node. Okay, so let me take the node too. So I have already copied the backup into my system, so I'm using WinSCP for transferring. Then use this IP and the root under the advanced session. I can use the authentication, then whatever the key I've used, connected. Okay, so somewhere I have the backup of SSM database, copy that. And also I have the backup of these directories also, so I'm copying that as well. So I have copied the backup files. Now log into this node, so which is the server which I am going to install the Cloudera server. So I don't remember the package name, so we can use the rem list all grep Cloudera. You'll get the name of the package. Okay, so these are the two packages which I need to install. And again, if you already not updated yum repo file, you need to update. So I'm going to install yum-y install this package as well as these two packages. So these two packages I need to install. Okay, so installation is completed. So now we will check whether these files are generated. Slash var lib ssm. Okay, so I have the backup here in my backup directory, and I am uncompressing this one. Okay, so this one var. So whatever the contents inside that, slash var lib cloudera. Then so we will check the permission of that. So this permission, so recursively changing the permission. So post to that, I'm just starting the db cloudera ssm fn server hyphen db start. So initially it is doing some configurations like database configuration, etc. So it takes some time. Okay, so it started. So we will have the credentials for DBs under this file etc cloudera ssm server, then db.properties. So this file contain all the configuration information. So you can just type psql hyphen u, so what is the username, then hyphen p, the port number which is using, and what are the db which is we are using, then the password. You can use this password, right? So and you can just list all the DBs here. You can see for SSM DB is created, and also we can just list all the users. So these are the users also created. I think this is fine. So now what we are going to use, so we are just we have already this database SSM. So and I have the dump of that database which is taken from my main or working cluster. So let me use psql, so just recover that psql hyphen u. Okay, so I don't remember the password again. Okay, so psql hyphen u, the username is this one. Sorry, username is this one, port is 7432, then db is this one, then write ssm db dump and provide the password. Okay, so it's loaded the data into this ssm database. Now we can start our Cloudera Manager server. Server Cloudera hyphen ssm hyphen server. Just doing a restart if any PID file exists. So I need to clean that. So for that, I'm just doing a restart. Then let me check the status. Yes, it's running. So I need this hostname, and I need to update this hostname across all the machines agent configuration file. For that, etc cloudera ssm agent, then config.ini change this IP address with new Cloudera Manager address. Then after that, service agent restart. So do this across all the machines, right? So go to the master login. Okay, so just service okay, so this is stopped. Okay, fine. / etc Cloudera SSM agent. Because my server IP is changed, so I need to update this and agent service I need to restart. So these steps I will be doing across all the nodes. So I have updated my Cloudera agent configuration file to point the new Cloudera server. So let me go to this browser and get this IP address and open new Cloudera server 7180. Okay, so login with my credentials, admin, the same credentials you can use. Okay, so now you can see the same components that you already there in your cluster, and also you can check all the hosts are getting heartbeats from here. Yes, everyone is getting heartbeats. Okay, fine. So let's start the services one by one. So first we will start Cloudera Manager agent services. So I'm going to, okay, so here you can see the stale configuration detected. Just click that. Because we have changed that URLs, I mean this IP address 154.179, and let me restart this Cloudera management service here. Okay, so this is done. Now you can see all the services here. Okay, so this time the Cloudera manager is on a different machine, and I completely migrated my Cloudera manager to here. Okay, so it's on 124 IP address, right? So earlier my Cloudera manager was here, and I have taken the backup and installed those components and whatever the database SSM I have completely recovered. So that is why the same service is showing, and what the same status, everything is same. So this is how you can recover Cloudera manager in case of any failure. So you need to have the back take the backup of SSM or whatever the databases and the files, like these two directories also you can take, so that you will be easily able to reconstruct the same Cloudera manager on another server. And the next thing you need to do is update the agent configuration file to point the new Cloudera manager server. So this is how we can recover or take the backup of the Cloudera server. So I hope this helped you, and please like it if you like the content. Also subscribe and write your comments in the below comment section. Thank you. Bye.